Hey Jackals! So I have a couple of videos on how to make subtitles from video or audio, but I don't have a good video when it comes to adding multiple subtitles in DaVinci Resolve. But that changes today, and thanks to manual, I'll show you how. Now let's get digital. Now let's imagine that this is my finished timeline and I want to add subtitles to it. The easiest way to do that would be to right click here, add a subtitle track, click on it, and create captions. Type something in, change duration, add a new one, type something in again, and so on. But in this case, I would only have this subtitle. What if I want to have multiple of them? Well, to change that, what we have to do is make a new timeline. And if this is the original timeline that you have, let's just make a new one. So timeline 7, it will be empty. So from this timeline, what we could copy is just the audio. So we would copy the audio. And if you want to display timelines like this, simply click on this icon. You'll have probably this one selected. So select this one. And as you can see, this will show up. And then once you click on plus, you'll simply select which timeline you want to show. So now in here, what I would do is add a new subtitle track. I would make my subtitles just like before. So I'll add a couple of subtitles. And just for the sake of it, I'll also change the style and the font. Just so we can see things clearly. So something like that. So now I've deleted the audio and I only have the subtitles left. What you do now is go back to timeline 6 and put timeline 7 on top and line it all the way to the left. Now if the timeline is shorter so that it's only from the start and to the end of the subtitles, what you can do is to add a subtitle at the beginning and remove the contents. So simply delete that, then go back to timeline 6 and you would put timeline 7 on and you should have the start like this. Now wherever the subtitles appear, the screen will be black. So if I scrub over, you can see that this is also black. So what you have to do is go into the composite mode and change this to add. And as you can see, the subtitles also keep the position. And if I go back to the timeline 7, change the position of the subtitles in the style, and then go back to timeline 6, the position changes. Now you can just repeat this process, so you would copy this again, make a new timeline, copy this in, add new subtitles, maybe from this point on, add the caption, add new, change the style, and change the color, change the size, and we can also change the position. And now if you go back to timeline 6, put the timeline 7 on. Now in this case, we also have the audio because I didn't delete it. So I could delete it here. And then put the subtitles at the top. Now the screen should go black, and it does. So simply change this back to add. And you'll have all of the different subtitles that you want. Now one thing that you also can do is when you have multiple subtitles, let's say that you want to emphasize just a part of the subtitle, so what you can do is select maybe this one and that one. You would then go to caption, uncheck use track style because this applies to the whole track. And now if you uncheck this, you will be changing the style for just the selected subtitles. So I can make the changes. Now this doesn't look the best if we have something overlapped. So what we have to do is maybe disable the background and change the color to something that's a little bit more nice to the eye. So maybe white. Let's check that out. This could be visible. So We'll just have to play around with the actual font colors and the background colors if you want to overlap the subtitles over an object. And the last thing that you can do if you have multiple subtitles and multiple people is to rename the timelines. So you can rename it when you make a new timeline. You can also right click here and rename it. And you can also rename the actual video, the video track. And you can also change the color if you want to. And that's how you'll easily know which track is actually for the subtitles. And I almost forgot, once you have all of the subtitles in the timelines and you have the main timeline done, go to the delivery page and go all the way till the end. In the subtitle settings, expand them, select export subtitles, and you'll have to bring them in. If you don't select this option, then only the subtitles that are in the main timeline will be visible. So if you don't have those subtitles, nothing will be visible. And that's why you have to select burn into video. Then simply add to render queue and render the video. And if you like this video, give it a thumbs up, subscribe to my channel if you want to see more DaVinci Resolve and video editing content, and hit the bell notification icon so you know when my next video comes out. I'm Simon, and until next time, Jackals, keep it digital!